With this video, I'll be showing an example of how to evaluate a source using the SIFT method developed by Mike Caulfield at Washington State University. This method was intended primarily for information distributed on social media or in other informal ways, but you can use it as well when working on a research paper. The S in SIFT stands for stop. Before you hit share, before you even start to delve into what the article or image is telling you, you stop and move on to the next step, which is investigate. When you investigate, you find out what you can about the publication the article is in and who its author is. You want to know who is telling you this information so you know how to analyze what they are saying. The F stands for find better coverage. If whatever source you found seems less trustworthy, you will next look to find a more trustworthy source that is covering this story. This could mean it's more authoritative or closer to the news source or event. T is for trace claims, quotes, and media to their original context. Maybe the article that you found isn't necessarily in a bad source, but it isn't the original source of the story and may have parts edited out that could be important for you to get a complete view on the topic. To get a fuller picture, you want to trace its claims back to their original context or source. Say, for example, that you are writing a paper about management and gender in the workplace, and you remember that you read this article, so you go back to it. Before you put it aside for your bibliography, stop and investigate what the publication is. Wikipedia can help in this context just as a check or to use if you found a source you've never heard about. You'll see that Glamour is a magazine that at its beginnings focused solely on entertainment, so it's not going to be the source doing the science described in the headline. Now that you've done enough investigating to know that this article is, at best, going to be a jumping-off point to finding a better source, scroll down and see that the article is summarizing a Harvard Business Review article on women in the workplace. This Harvard Business Review article was the one that cited the scientific study mentioned in the headline of the Glamour article. But even in this summary of the study, you'll see that the results don't really match with what's said in the headline. Let's trace it back to its original context. You can use the link to get to the study. If you're on campus, since it's in a database that we subscribe to, you can click right through. If you're off campus, you can navigate to Scopus on our databases page, and then search for the title of the article. You'll be able to get to it with the Find Full Text link. But even within Scopus, there are other things you can do to investigate this new source. You can take a look at the author and see that they've written a lot of other articles about language and gender. You can investigate the journal and see that it's cited a lot within other language journals and has been in publication since the 1980s. From this investigation, you'll feel confident that the original context for the study mentioned in this article is in a respected academic journal by someone with expertise in the field. Reading articles outside of your field can be difficult, but you can take a look at the abstract and see if it lines up with what's reported in the popular source that you found. In the abstract, it says that a significant result was that participants interrupted female speakers more, but it doesn't say whether there was a significant difference in which gender the interrupter was. To see the full findings, go into the results section to look for the results chart. On this chart, you'll see something like what was summarized in the article. It says that both men and women interrupt women more often than they interrupt men. So by using the SIFT method, you took an article that may have made you report erroneous information in your paper if you'd just taken it at face value, and used it to find a more reliable source that gives you more nuanced information. And it only took you a few minutes. Thank you for watching, and please feel free to contact us if you're having trouble telling if a source is reliable or how to trace back a claim to its original context.